Children to the session 2 today, then we will be talking about types of expenditure in this session. So primarily I'm taking up 3 types of expenditure, but prior to that let us understand what is expenditure. Expenditure is money spent by the business firm in order to get purchase goods and services or to purchase an asset or any other expense. So primarily we have 3 categories of expenditure. So first we'll discuss with the capital expenditure. Capital expenditure, as the word suggests, that it is non-recurring in nature. This expense is not done on a day-to-day basis. It happens only once upon a time. Okay, so what are the precise features of capital expenditure that we can see over the board? Money spent on the purchase of fixed assets, not on goods and services, but to get fixed assets. Fixed assets means in the form of land, building, plant, machinery, which are to be utilized in a business for a large number of years. This is the money which is spent for the purchase of any fixed asset or improving any existing asset. If you have a fixed asset, suppose you have a building and you want to increase one more room in that building. So the expenditure which you'll put up to increase one more room, that will be considered as capital expenditure. Any money which is spent either on the purchase of any fixed asset or improving the existing fixed asset will be considered as a capital expenditure, because it will happen once upon a time. Every day you cannot purchase a building, every day you will not purchase land. So they are non-recurring in nature. Now second one is that these kind of expenditures increase the earning capacity of the business. How the earning capacity will be increased? Because of the increase in the scale of operation. For example, if you were having one machinery, naturally less work. If you are having 5 machineries, more goods can be produced. So they increase the earning capacity of the business. Now the third feature is they provide benefit for a longer period of time, generally more than 1 year. So these are the expenditures which will provide benefit to the business firm, not for a short period. They will be providing benefit for a large number of years. For example, if you purchase a building will not collapse in 1 month or in 1 year. It will go for near about 10 to 12 years or say 20 years. So they provide a benefit for a longer period of time. Now what is the fourth feature? They are shown as assets in the balance sheet as they are created. These type of expenditures will be shown as assets in the business firm's balance sheet. Why? Because the assets will be created after having such expenditure. If you will spend 25 lakh to get a building, then building will be created. So that's why we will show this expenditure as building in balance sheet. On which side? On the asset side. Now, there can be certain examples of this kind of expenditure that can be purchase of machinery, purchase of building, purchase of land, purchase of computer, purchase of any other thing which can be utilized in the business for a longer period of time, and that is generally not meant for sale. They are called capital expenditures. Now, moving on to the second category, which is also very, very important, that is revenue expenditure. I'll tilt my phone a little so that it gives you a clear view. These are of recurring nature. They will happen repeatedly. You will not spend once upon a time on the purchase of raw material. You will first, one raw material has been processed, sold, and another you have to purchase. So these kind of expenditures are called revenue expenditures because they are recurring in nature. Now what is the other precise feature? Money spent on the purchase of goods and services can be referred to as revenue expenditures. Because they are generally happening in day-to-day course of business. You have to purchase a kind of a raw material or goods, you have to process it and you have to sell it. So money spent on the purchase of goods and services in the normal course of business is considered as revenue expenditure. They do not increase the earning capacity. They will not increase the earning capacity, rather they will help in maintaining the existing earning capacity. For example, if you have purchased a machinery, machinery will increase your earning capacity. But if you are doing oiling of the machinery, if you are doing repairs of the machinery, so oiling and repairs, which is regularly required, will be considered as revenue expenditure. Then we have the third feature, their benefit exhausts within a year. Their benefit. Their benefits will be exhausted in a year. they will not be utilized for a large number of years. Their benefit will be exhausted. Now we have one more feature. Let me show you. They are shown on the debit side of trading and P&L account. They will be shown as expense on the debit side of which account? Trading and P&L account, which is also a recurring nature account, nominal account. Then examples of revenue expenditure can be cost of goods sold, it can be salary given to the employee, it can be rent given for any rental property that you are using in the business, it can be electricity bill, it can be telephone bill, it can be anything which happens monthly or repeatedly in the business. So these are the revenue expenditures. Now moving on to the deferred revenue expenditure, which is also one of the very important categories of expenditure and very, very essential to learn. Okay, so we have deferred revenue expenditure over here. It's a mix of capital and revenue expenditure. Say they are revenue in nature, but their benefit is available for a number of years. Although they are repeatedly done in the business, they are of repetitive nature, but their benefit lasts for not only 1 year, their benefit will last over a number of years. As we can say in revenue expenditure, their benefit will exhaust only in 1 year. You can see over here. The revenue expenditure's benefit will exhaust in a year, but not deferred revenue expenditure. Although they are repetitive in nature, but their benefit will not exhaust within one accounting year. Their benefit will be exhausting in more than 1 year. Generally a span of 3 to 7 years. Not as large as capital expenditure, say 20 years, 50 years, no. Generally 3 to 7 years. Then they are divided into parts. One basic feature of deferred revenue expenditure is that they are divided into parts. Generally, they are also called as fictitious assets that we have discussed in the previous session. Let us see with an example. You can have a look at the example over here. Suppose we have done a huge expenditure on advertising. Say rupees 2 lakh we have paid to an advertising company for 4 years, and we asked it that you have to provide us your services for 4 years. Now what is the 1 year expense? 50,000 is the 1 year expense. So how we are going to show this 50,000? In first year, 50,000 will be shown as a revenue expenditure in which account? On the debit side of P&L account. And remaining 1,50,000, which has still not been used, will be shown as assets in the balance sheet. This is the condition in first year. That 50,000 is the expense for this year, and then 1,50,000, which will be remaining, which will give the benefits in another 3 years, will be taken to the asset side of the balance sheet, because still 1,50,000 has not been utilized, because for entire 4 years we have given rupees 2 lakh. Okay, so in the second year again 50,000 will be shown as P&L account, debit side, revenue expense, and 1 lakh rupees will be shown as an asset on the balance sheet, because now another 50,000 has been utilized and still 1 lakh rupees are remaining. Similarly, in the third year again 50,000 will be shown on the debit side of P&L account and remaining 50,000 will be shown in the balance sheet. In the last year, we will only show the debit side P&L account 50,000 and nothing will be shown as an asset. So this is how deferred revenue expenditure works, that a part of it which is utilized will be shown in the debit side of P&L, and the part which has not been utilized will be shown on the asset side of balance sheet. So these are the three precise categories of expenditures that we have done today. Capital expenditure, a long-term expenditure for the purchase of fixed assets, generally over a long period of time. And revenue expenditure, which is happening for day-to-day running of the business, generally gets exhausted within a span of 1 year. And they are generally small in nature. Then deferred revenue expenditure, a combination of two. A part of it will be shown as a revenue expenditure in P&L account, and a part of it, another part of it, which has not been used in a one particular year, will be shown in the asset side of balance sheet. So hope to see you in the next session with another topic. This topic has been completed now.